I think we could all agree on one thing, and that is when it comes to achieving success, whether it's from our personal lives or our professional lives, it's a top priority for all of us. But have you ever stopped and think how we unintentionally might have gotten away of doing that? Self-sabotage is a very, very real thing, and it could be a major obstacle onto the path of achieving our goals. So how do we end up doing this thing? How do we, you know, unknowingly get in our way to achieve our success in life? Well, often it's because, you know, we're stuck in our ways, we may be afraid of change, or we might not just be aware of the patterns that are holding us back in life. It's very easy to point and, you know, make excuses, but at the end of the day, we have to take responsibility for our own actions and, you know, recognize the ways in which we are sabotaging ourselves. What's even more interesting is that we often, you know, do it when we're on the brink of success. We would get so close to achieving our goals, and then all of the sudden, something will just start to derail us. It's like if we're like allergic to success or something like that. But the good news is that once we become aware of these patterns, we can start to make, you know, changes and start to take control again of our own success. So with that being said, in today's video, I want to dive into the top 5 reasons that may be ruining your own success. The first way that we may be sabotaging our success is playing the safe card. We might get, you know, too comfortable with the status quo, and, you know, that's when we start to be afraid to take a little bit of risks or try new things in life. This fear of uncertainty is what holds us back from achieving our true potential in life. For example, have you ever had maybe like a business idea, but you are too afraid to, you know, pursue it because you didn't know if it will work out in the end? Or maybe you've been stuck in a dead-end job because you're afraid to, you know, take that leap and pursue something new. The second way we self-sabotage our success is by comparing ourselves to others. Now, this is a personal one that I've struggled a lot, but the rule of thumb is never, ever, ever compare yourself to others. And here's why. We can get caught up in the trap of thinking that, you know, someone else's success is better than our own. And then that's when we start to doubt our own abilities. The comparison game is honestly just going to be a losing battle or a lose-lose scenario for yourself. Because, you know, there's that saying, there's always going to be a bigger fish in the sea or something like that. Same kind of concept. Because, you know, there's always going to be someone that seems more successful or accomplished than you, me, or anyone else. For instance, have you ever, you know, maybe scrolled through social media and, you know, it felt like that you're just not good enough because someone else's highlights reel looks more impressive than our own reality? The third way we might be self-sabotaging our own success is procrastination. We put off important tasks until the very last minute. I know back in my days in school, I would do that. When it's the weekend, I will always put my homework in the very last minute on Sunday night. Now that I look back on it, I'm like, why did I do that? And then we will start to wonder why we're not achieving our goals. This habit of delaying the important tasks is a surefire way to ensure that we don't reach our full potential. For example, have you ever put off a project or a task because you didn't feel like doing it, and then ultimately ended up rushing through it the very last minute? I know I have. The fourth method how we might be self-sabotaging ourselves is the dwelling on negativity. We focus too much on our failures and mistakes, and we end up beating ourselves up over them. This negative self-talk is just a surefire way to sabotage our confidence and our motivations. For instance, have you ever maybe made a mistake on a, you know, school project and then spend the next week dwelling on its intent on moving forward? My fifth and final method on how we may be self-sabotaging our success is the lacking accountability. We don't set, you know, enough clear goals for ourselves, and we don't hold ourselves accountable for achieving them. This lack of accountability leads to, you know, the lack of motivation and discipline, which can be a major obstacle on the path to success. For example, have you ever maybe set a New Year's resolution and to only forget that revolutionary goal by February? I know I have. But all of these ways we sabotage our success, I think the most important thing to get out of it is the fear of uncertainty. This fear always is the reason that holds us back from taking the risks and pursuing our dreams. And it's often the root cause of the many of the patterns of self-sabotage. When we're afraid of the unknown, we tend to play it safe. We might start to procrastinate. We will start to compare ourselves to others' success, you know, dwell on the negativity and the lack of accountability. But when we face our fears and take control of our actions, that's when we start to take back in control and we can now achieve our true potential. In conclusion, self-awareness is the key of achieving our success. We have to be aware in which ways we are sabotaging ourselves and take deliberate action to change our patterns of behavior. By recognizing these five methods that may be self-sabotaging our success, we can start to make a positive change and take back control of our own destiny. Thank you and God bless you for taking a few minutes out of your day checking out this video. I hope it was helpful and enlightful. And as always, I love to hear your stories. If you have any in the comments or any input, advice, recommendations for this video. And also, feel free to leave any recommendation requested subject matters you would like me to tackle on for the next future videos. I'm more happy to do that. I'm Adam representing Team SOS. Thank you and God bless you. And in case I don't see you on the next one, make sure you have yourself a good morning, afternoon, evening, and most importantly, good night. Signing off. Peace.